Hello again, welcome to another look at the weekend and next week's weather, courtesy of netweather.tv, and I had been hoping that at long last I could promise you a taste of late spring, early summer, call it what you like, but at the moment that's sort of the last thing I can do, although give it a while, have a bit of patience, and maybe later on in the week, next week that is, and into the weekend, things could change and high pressure could take over and it may well warm up. But if we look at the surface level pressure pattern at the moment, we have low pressure over Scandinavia and another one developing around the English Channel. Now, the Scandinavian low isn't really going to affect our weather. It moves away quite readily. But the one over the Channel drifts slowly north and then swings away southeast, at least just for a time. And that means to say we're going to find strong and cool northeasterly winds picking up, as well as getting some outbreaks of rain. So certainly not much like middle or late May. Now that area of low pressure looks as if it's going to remain to the south of us, or at least around us, and actually, having declined a little bit, it's going to re-deepen, it's going to deepen again. And as pressure builds across the north at the same time, those northeasterly winds are going to increase, and there could well be gales around in places, especially along the east coast and in the southeastern core of the country, and there may well be a lot of rain around as well. Eventually the low drifts away eastwards onto the continent, and the high pressure over Scandinavia takes over. But even when that happens, those cool winds will persist along the east coast. But it does mean to say that at long last, as we head towards the weekend, we could well see some fine weather setting in and some reasonable temperatures, at least that is away from that east coast. But the timing of it all is rather uncertain, especially what's going to happen around about Tuesday, Wednesday time, just how quickly that area of low pressure will move away and take the rain with it. Now, if we have a look at the temperature of the atmosphere, you see we start off quite cool with the greeny shades there. Warmer air does move in from the east quite early on, the colours going round into the yellowy oranges, certainly not the hot crimsons. But that means to say we are going to get, although we're not going to notice it all that much because the winds will be stronger, they'll be coming in off the North Sea, and the temperature of the North Sea is not very high. So in the lower levels, we'll be picking up those cool temperatures and feeling quite cool. But above, there will be some warm air, but if nothing else, that's really only going to increase the amount of moisture in the atmosphere and increase the threat of some outbreaks of fairly heavy and thundery rain, especially in the southeast. So then, on a day-to-day basis, we start on Friday, where the north of Scotland will have sunny spells and perhaps just a few showers. Not too bad a day, really. Some early frost around, incidentally, so do bear that in mind. Too early to put the bedding plants out just yet. For southern Scotland, Northern Ireland, Northern England, it does look as if it will be cloudy, with some rain around too. And this will push a little bit further southwards into the north of Wales during the course of the day. And it's going to be pretty cold too and breezy. In fact, cold enough for some of that rain to be turning to snow over the Scottish hills. South Wales, central and southern England probably have a mostly dry day, or these will be mostly dry to begin with. But even here it will become increasingly cloudy, with some occasional rain or drizzle breaking out later on in the day. On Saturday, again, quite simple for Scotland, dry with sunny spells, again a cold and maybe frosty start in places. England, Wales and Northern Ireland, though, look as if they'd be cloudy with outbreaks of rain and a fairly cool breeze too, although some brightness may hang on in the southeastern corner until later in the day. And if that happens in the southeast, at least temperatures there will be close to normal, closer to normal. Now by Sunday, that cool northeasterly wind will have picked up across the whole country. It's still going to be reasonably fine though in Scotland, Northern Ireland and the north of England. That's after again a touch of frost in places. But it does look as if it's going to turn out to be a wet and fairly windy day across southern England and South Wales. Although the rain will tend to peter out in perhaps the more sheltered parts of Wales and the southwest of England, the Western Midlands, as the day goes on. But at the same time, as the rain dies out in those western areas, it may well turn heavier in the southeastern corner, and it could even turn thundery as well during the evening and overnight into Monday morning. So Monday starts cool, wet and windy across central and eastern parts of England. A fine start to the day though for Scotland, Northern Ireland, Wales and the southwest of England, but that rain will move across into the southwestern parts of England as the day goes on. Now it is going to be a very windy day in most places. There could even be gales in the east, especially along the coast, And as a result of that, of course, it's going to feel pretty cold, especially when it's raining at the same time as it's very windy. It is a bit problematical, though. The exact position of that low is going to be a problem to get right. And of course, it will eventually transfer away eastwards onto the continent. The earlier it does so, the sooner the rain dies away. But at the moment, we think it's going to be pretty wet in those areas on Monday, and it could well still be wet on Tuesday, although again, the low might just about manage to slip far enough away for the rain to be over the North Sea and the near continent. But it's difficult to say, and I think we must allow for the fact that many eastern, especially southeastern parts of the country will again be cool and windy with some further outbreaks of rain, but it's very uncertain. Whereas the more northern and western parts with shelter, although be fairly cool and breezy, they should be mostly dry with some bright spells. And then on Wednesday, again, the rain continuing to move away, so the weather slowly becoming brighter and drier just about everywhere, although still along that east coast there will be a cool breeze. And that process continues through the latter part of the week. Very gradually it becomes drier and brighter and more settled across all parts. Still be some chilly nights though, and it's still going to feel quite chilly along and near to that east coast. Well, that's all from me for the time being. I hope you have a lovely weekend and that you can join me again this time next week. Goodbye for now.